Oberlicht was an artistic collective at the very beginning, and mainly we support young artists, and that's our main objective, and help them produce their works and integrate into international context of art. But this is now one of the many directions which we work on. The other direction is related to research on public space transformations. We take Chisinau as a starting point to observe how the society changes by looking at the city, how the city changes. Because the city speaks in a way very clearly what are the changes, how politics works, how economy works, what kind of people you meet in the city, and so on. And the way it transforms also is a kind of, on a micro level, it speaks on how the society in general transforms, what are the trends of transformation. So we see a lot of public spaces which disappear, being replaced by commercial type of activities. We see how some public spaces used for political messages. This is also a way to understand how the whole country works. So this direction of research on public space transformations is kind of a newer direction, which materialized in a public space library. We have a physical library which we run, and we collect books on art, architecture, and theory. But also it materialized in a series of events, like a series of conferences about Chisinau and other cities, a newsletter on public space, and also reading groups. So we invite people to read some texts and then discuss these texts. The other direction which we develop more recently, we call it advocacy action. It's at the very beginning. We cannot say that we did a lot in this sense, but what we try to do is to communicate, to pass a message from the communities that we work with, and these are artistic community, active in Chisinau. This is also an activist community which deals with issues related to the city, but also other communities of inhabitants that we are in touch with in those places where we develop some activities. So in advocacy action part, we try to pass the message from these communities to the decision makers, because there is no communication between these two layers, and we try to be to link them, to link the real issues with those who have the power to solve the issues. And we pass some recommendations on the level of cultural policies, for example, or on the level of urban policies. Then we also have some activities which are related to community building. We have also non-formal education, some models which we developed as part of different projects, and we also do editing and publishing activity, and also some translations and dissemination of the results which we managed to obtain. We have a magazine called Postbox Magazine, and we also print some publications, and we use different web pages for communicating about the different issues which we find relevant. We managed to produce our projects due to established links and due to the networks which we managed to develop in the meantime with other organizations from other countries which work in a similar way or have similar objectives. And most of the resources which we use today are coming through European cultural programs and also through cultural institutes. So this is our main resource. We used to work a lot as volunteers, and we didn't have any space. That was a long period of time which also in a way pushed us out into the public space and made us question what happens to the common spaces which belong to the community, to everyone, And why wouldn't we use also them for our activities? And but right now we are struggling to get funds and to be able to continue with the programs that we started. Yes, our team is kind of interdisciplinary at this moment. So we have also, we used to have architects in the team. Now we have one sociologist. I'm myself an artist and curator. And the other people are also coming from various fields. So we integrate different practices in our projects and different people. The public space produces a kind of common ground for us to meet and to work together. And it's also a way to respond in a more efficient way to the challenges which we face in Chișinău, but also in other cities from the region.